फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द टाइम एंड डिस्टेंस. सो दैट इज द बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्पीड इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस अपॉन टाइम. वेन एवर यू आर चेंजिंग एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर टू मीटर पर सेकेंड, देन यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई 5/18. एंड वेन एवर यू हैव टू चेंज मीटर पर सेकेंड टू किलोमीटर पर आवर, देन यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई बाई 18/5. That is the first trick. If a certain distance is covered at x kilometer per hour and the same distance is covered at y kilometer per hour, then the average speed during the whole journey is 2xy upon x plus y. Means if the distance is same, then you have to use this formula. If the distance is not same, then you cannot use it. So now the first question: a man covers a certain distance by a car at 70 km per hour, and he returns back. Now he is coming back, from starting point, riding on a scooter at 55 km per hour. What is the average speed? So you have to remember, whenever the distance is same, he at first go from here to here, then come back. So in the first phase and second phase, the distance is same. So you have to use this formula. So that will be 2xy upon x plus y. So what is x? X is 70 and 55. So into 70 into 55 upon 70 plus 55. If you will calculate, then you will get the answer. That is 61.6 km per hour. So it is taking 2 or 3 seconds to complete this question. Now second one is, a man covers a certain distance between his house and office on a scooter. This is his house and this is office. Okay. Covers a distance between his house and office on a scooter. Okay. Having an average speed of 30 km per hour, he is late by 10 minutes. However, with a speed of 40 km per hour, he reaches his office 5 minutes earlier. Find the distance between his house and office. So, a man covers a certain distance between his house and office on a scooter having an average speed of 30 km per hour. He has total number of average speed is 30 km per hour. Now he is late 10 minutes. So, however, with the speed of 40 km per hour, he reaches his office 5 minutes earlier. Okay. If he is taking this speed, then he is 5 minutes earlier. If he is taking this speed, then he is 10 minutes late. Now he is asking, this is a very good question. I will solve this question in this paper. So, also you can solve this problem by our trick. So I will give you one trick, or we will use the basic method at first. Let the distance be x kilometer, time taken to cover x kilometer at 30 km per hour is equal to x upon 30 hours. Now, time taken to cover x kilometer at 40 km per hour is equal to x upon 40 hours. If the distance is this, you know that speed is equal to distance upon time. So 30 km per hour, then this is distance upon this is e. We are finding the time is equal to distance upon speed. Okay. टाइम टेकन टू कवर एक्स किलोमीटर एट 40 किलोमीटर पर आवर इज इक्वल टू एक्स अपॉन 40. नाउ डिफरेंस डिफरेंस बिटवीन टाइम टेकन इज इक्वल टू 15 मिनट बिकॉज द डिफरेंस इन टाइम इज 15 मिनट बिफोर ही रीच्ड 10 मिनट लेट देन 5 मिनट अर्ली. सो 10 प्लस 5 इज इक्वल टू 15. द डिफरेंस इज 15. सो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टाइम टेकन इज इक्वल टू 15 मिनट. सो दैट इज 1 अपॉन 4 आवर. इन दिस कंडीशन यू नो दैट दैट इज द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट इज द सेकेंड टाइम. सो x अपॉन 30 माइनस x अपॉन 40 द डिफरेंस इज 1 अपॉन 4. नाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट x. इफ यू सॉल्व देन यू विल गेट x इज इक्वल टू 30 किलोमीटर. दिस इज द फर्स्ट मेथड. सेकेंड मेथड आई विल गिव यू वन ट्रिक. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इट. वेन एवर यू हैव सच टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम ए मैन कवर्स ए सर्टेन डिस्टेंस बिटवीन हिज हाउस एंड ऑफिस ऑन स्कूटर or bus anything having an average speed of 30 km per hour, he is late by 10 minutes. However, with the speed of this, he is 5 minutes earlier. Find the distance between the house and office. Then you have to use this one. Required distance, REQUIRED, required DISTANCE, distance is equal to product, PRODUCT, product of two speed upon difference 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 of two speed into difference between arrival time. Okay, so the product of two speed, that is 30 into 40. Because at first 30, then 40, okay, 30 into 40, now upon difference in two speed, 40 minus 30, into difference between arrival time, that is 10 minute late and 5 minute earlier. So what is the difference? Before 10 minute, then 5 minute, and total is 60. Okay, difference between arrival and time means before 10 minute late, after then 10 minute earlier. So 10 plus 5 upon 60, that is the difference. So if you will calculate, then you will get the 30 kilometer. Very simple. Now next question. A man walking with a speed of 5 kilometer per hour reaches his target 5 minute late. Okay. 5 minute late. Suppose the exact time was t, so it means that he reached t minus 5 minute. If he walks at a speed of 6 km per hour, he reaches on time. Okay, so this is very simple. You know that speed is equal to distance upon time. When a man walking with a speed of 5, if he has 5 km per hour, then distance, I don't know about the distance, time is t minus 5, but you have to remember this is minute and this is kilometer per hour. Okay, so you have to change it. Now second, when he is taking 6 kilometer per hour, then he reaches on time. It means that this is d upon t. So you have two equation you have to calculate. This is the first method. Now the second method also very simple. The difference in time is equal to 10 minute. Before a man walking with a speed of 5 kilometer, okay, so difference is 5 upon 60. Difference is 60, 5 upon 60. He reached 5 minute late and after then he reached on time, means 5 upon 60. Okay, so you have to use the formula. Again, we are using the same formula. The formula is this. So D is equal to the first speed 5 into 6 upon 6 minus 5 into difference in between arrival time. So arrive 5 plus 0 because he reached on time upon 60. That is the answer. Very simple. Again, a boy walking at a, suppose you are not getting, you will solve, then you will understand. A boy walking at a speed of 10 km per hour reaches his school 15 minutes late. Okay, this is your distance, and you reached 15 minutes late, means t plus 15 minutes. This is your original time. Next time he increased his speed. Now he increased his speed by 2 km per hour, but still he late 5 minutes. Again he late 5 minutes, means again you are taking 5 minutes extra. Okay, before you have 10 km per hour speed, 10 km per hour, and after then 12 km per hour. Okay, so still you have 5 minutes. Find the distance between this. Very simple question. Again we will use the same formula. You have to find the difference. Now in this question, the difference in time is equal to 15. Before he was 15 minutes late, again 5 minutes late. So 15 minus 5 is equal to 10 minutes. You have to remember actually what is this. This is the exact time. So in the first question we have done 10 plus 5, then 5 plus 0, then now 15 minus 5. Why we are subtracting here? Why we are adding here? This is the question. This is your original time. Okay. And in the first question, in the second question, he reached 0, means at original time, and he took 5 minutes late, means 5 minutes late means extra time. This is the extra time, and he is reaching before, means earlier. So whenever you have earlier such type of cases, the first question was before he reached earlier, and he took extra time, so we have add here. That is 0, he reached on time, and he took extra time, 5 plus 0. Now in this question he took 15 minutes extra, again he took 5 minutes extra, means he reached 15 minutes late, then again he reached 5 minutes late. So now in both condition you are here. Okay, so the difference in time is 15 minus 5 is equal to 10. So whenever you have the data is here, then this value, it is already minus V, and this is plus V. So whenever the two data are here, then you will subtract. Whenever here also you are subtracting, that is also 5 minus 0 actually, but 0, that is also same value. Then 0 is neither negative nor positive. So whenever this data, so you have done also same thing, 10 minus 5, but minus plus, so that is also plus. So all are same, you have to remember. So 15 minus 5 is equal to 10. So 10 minutes. So it means that your total difference time is equal to 10 upon 60 is equal to 1 upon 6. So your distance is equal to your first speed 10, second speed 12 upon 12 minus 10. Again same formula we are putting. Difference between arrival time, that is into 10 upon 60. Okay, that is 1 upon 6. Now you can calculate. Very simple. You have to remember this one. Whenever you are reaching earlier, so your data is minus V. If you are reaching after the original time, so your value, you are here. So in this condition, every time you are subtracting, but if the data is here, then you have to put minus. Okay, if the data is here, then you have to put plus. Here this is plus, he is taking 10 minutes extra, but he is reaching 5 minutes early. If he is increasing the speed, then he is reaching 5 minutes early. So 5, that is minus actually, but you have to subtract both the data. So 10 minus minus 5 is equal to 10 plus 5. So that is positive, because every time we are subtracting. Okay. So we have written here difference between the arrival time, means difference between the time. Okay. I think that you understand. Now the next question, if again you have any suspense, a boy goes to school at a speed of 3 km per hour, okay, and returns to village at a speed of 2 km per hour, if he takes 5 hours in all, what is the distance between school and this? Okay, a boy goes to school, this is your school, at a speed of 3 km per hour, 3 km per hour, and returns to village, this is your village, okay, at first go and come back, at a speed of 2 km per hour, if he takes 5 hour in all, means this is t1 time, this is t2 time, means t1 plus t2 is equal to 5. Very simple, you know that speed is equal to distance upon time. You have to remember distance is same. So at first he took 3 is equal to distance upon time 1. So t1 is equal to d upon 3. So your t1 is equal to d upon 3. Similarly, your t2 is equal to d upon 2. Now t1 plus t2 is equal to d upon 3 plus d upon 2, and this value is 5. But what is hour? And that is also kilometer per hour. Okay. So 5 is equal to this. Now you have to solve this question. Very simple. So we are just taking the extra page. Your t1 plus t2 is equal to d upon 3 plus d upon 2. So t1 plus t2 is equal to 5 is equal to d 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 2. Now you have to calculate. 3 2 jar 6, 3 plus 2 5, d is equal to 5. 5 and 5 cancel, d is equal to 6 km. Very simple. Now next question, a motor car goes a journey in 10 hours, the first half at 21 km per hour and the second half is 24 km per hour, find the distance. Okay, a motor car goes a journey 10 hours, the first half at 21, this is 21 km per hour, and this is half 24 km per hour. Okay, you know that speed is equal to distance upon time. Okay, so so we don't know the this one, but we know if this is x, suppose, or okay, I have given you one trick. Whenever the distance is same, then the average speed, you can also calculate by the help of this formula. Or you can use this formula. Distance is equal to 2 into time into S1 into S2 upon S1 plus S2. That is the speed. Speed 1, speed 2. So, very simple. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Okay, so now 2 into time. Time is, what is the time? 10 hours. Okay, into S1, speed is 21 kilometer and 24 kilometer. 21 into 24 upon 21 plus 24. If you will calculate, then you will get 224 kilometer. That is your original speed. Okay. Now next question. The distance between two stations, Delhi and Amritsar. One is Delhi and one is Amritsar. The distance between two station Delhi and Amritsar is 450 km. 450 km. Okay. A train starts at 4 p.m. from Delhi to Amritsar. At 4 p.m. 4 p.m. from Delhi to Amritsar. Okay. From Delhi to Amritsar at an average speed 60 km/h. Another train starts from Amritsar to Delhi. Now another train is coming here, okay, with speed and at time 3:20 p.m. okay, and moves toward Delhi to an average speed 80 km. One minute. A train starts at 4 p.m. from Delhi to and moves toward Amritsar at an average speed 60 km/h. Another train starts from Amritsar at 3:20 p.m. and moves toward Delhi at an average 80 km/h. How far from Delhi will the two trains meet? Okay, when they will meet? Okay, one train is going from here to here and one is going from here to here. When they will meet? So we have to check when they will meet. Very interesting question. You can also think one boyfriend is coming from here to here and girlfriend is coming from here to here with a speed of this and this, when they will meet. Okay, you can also think. So how to solve this question? I will take one extra paper. Suppose this is a very interesting question. Suppose the trains meet at a distance of x kilometer from Delhi. Okay, so let the train from Delhi to Amritsar be A and B respectively. We are just thinking that the train A and train B, you can put any name. So in this condition, time, this is A and this is B, we are thinking. Now time taken by B to cover 450 minus x kilometer. So this train, it will take 450 minus x, and that is from Delhi to this x kilometer. We have written distance from x kilometer. Okay, it is equal to minus time taken by A to cover x kilometer is equal to what they have written. They start 4 p.m. and this start 3:20 p.m. So time taken by B and time taken by A, the difference in speed, again the difference in speed, it is 4 p.m. and that is 3:20 p.m. So what is the difference? So 4 p.m. and this is 3:20 p.m. difference in speed is 40 minute. So we have written 40, so but that is kilometer, so we are just thinking about this is a kilometer per hour, so 40 upon 60, so that is the difference in speeds. Now you know that time taken. You know that speed is equal to distance upon time. So time is equal to distance upon speed. So similarly, we will put the data here. Time is equal to distance upon speed. Distance is 450 minus x upon speed. For the first train, your speed is 60. Okay. For the first train, okay, this is 450. Okay, sorry. Train B, it is going from here to here and it is taking 80. This is x kilometer. From here to here, x kilometer, and from here to here, 450 minus x. Okay, so to cover this distance, so that is speed of this train B is 80 kilometer per hour. Okay, so time taken by B to cover this distance is equal to 4 distance upon speed. Speed is 80 minus time taken by A, that is x upon 60, and its speed is equal to 60, and total difference is 40 upon 60. If you will calculate, then you will get x is equal to 170. Okay, so your x is, they will meet at 170 kilometer, but we have to find when the time. Okay, we have to find at what time they will meet. So time taken by A to cover 170 kilometer is equal to 170 upon 60. Speed is equal to distance upon time is equal to 2 hours 50 minutes. If you will calculate, so 2 hours 50 minutes means 4 p.m. After 2 hours, you can think. Because 4 p.m. the train is started. After 2 hours 50 minutes, it is meeting with another train. So that is 6:50 p.m. I think that you understand. Now another question. Walking 3/4 of his usual speed, a person is 10 minutes late to his office. Find his usual time to cover the distance. Okay. So walking 3/4 of his usual speed, a person is 10 minutes late. So now we can think that speed is equal to distance upon time. This is speed, everything is usual. Usual speed, time, okay, for distance d. Let we are just thinking. Walking 3/4 of his usual speed. His speed is s, but he is now taking 3/4. 3/4 of his usual speed. A person is 10 minutes late, means distance upon time is 10 minutes late. Whatever he is taking time, now he is 10 minutes late. Late means he is taking 10 minutes extra. That is minute, you have to think. Find the usual, very simple. Now you have, this is equation number first and this is equation number second. Solve now, very simple. You have to think only this is a minute. You have to convert this minute to hour, because this is, this speed, it is in kilometer per hour. Okay, so you have to calculate the distance. You have to calculate the distance. So another there is no another solutions, only one solutions. So if you will calculate it, then you will get your distance, that is this s you have to put here, then you can get the time. Whenever you have got time, then after then you can calculate the distance also. So this is very simple. Or we can also do another thing. What another? The difference in speed the difference in speed this time, the difference in time is equal to 10 minute. Okay, the before question I have given you. Another question I have given you, the difference in speed. I have written something in a paper. You have remember that required distance is equal to product of the two speed, difference of the two speeds or something like that. So we are just using the same method here. We are taking another page. Let the usual time is equal to t. Time taken at 3/4 of the usual speed is equal to 4/3x. Usual time is equal to d. This speed is equal to distance upon time. So you have taken this time taken at 3/4 of his usual speed is equal to 4/3 t, because t is equal to distance upon speed. It was 4/3, 3/4. So after this, this is 4/3 t, and distance is, let this is four upon 3t. Okay, so if you will difference the time, this time and this time, 4/3 t minus t, and that difference is 10. So now you can calculate easily. So this is 4 minus 3 is equal to t upon 3 is equal to 10. So it implies that t is equal to 30 minute. This is in minute, you have to remember. So you have got this one, very simple. No need to just calculate this, that will, it will take more time. That is also solution, but that is the best solution. Another same question, if you are not getting, same question again. Running 4/3 of his usual speed, a person improves his timing by 10 minutes, means he is reaching 10 minutes earlier. Find his usual time to cover the distance. Same question. Again, I will give you one another formula. This usual time is equal to improved time, upon 1 minus 1 divided by 4/3. Okay, you can solve it. And the before usual time is equal to late time upon 1 divided 3/4 minus 1. Now check. At first, this question, he is reaching after 10 minute. Late time is 10 upon 1 divided this 3/4, whatever the data they have given us, 3/4 minus 1. Okay, if you will calculate, then you will get your 30 minute. And same thing, usual time is equal to improved time. Improved time is 10 minute, is equal to 10 minute upon 1 minus 1 divided by 4/3, means whatever the data they have given us, 4/3. Now that is 1 divided by 4/3 means 3/4. Okay, so 1 minus 3/4, you can calculate, then you will get your answer, that is 40 minute. Very simple. If you know the trick, then you can solve all the problems very easily. So this is a very simple problem. Okay, we have done a lot of problems, and after some time also we will upload many tricks, okay, to crack your exam. So this time we are just we decided to stop our service now. Okay, thank you so much.